three hypertrophy tips coming to you live from the World Congress on Hypertrophy. You're not going to want to miss this. This is where the world's experts have come together to give you the biggest, baddest tips, talking science and application. I'm going to dump the pump, hit the showers, get some better light behind me, but we are starting right now. What is going on? My name is David Barr. If you're looking to get bigger, faster, stronger, get leaner, go longer, hit that subscribe and then the little bell so you don't miss the latest tips and tricks. Today, coming to you from Minneapolis, Minnesota, World Congress on Hypertrophy. Got the world's experts. There's some stuff I've never heard anyone talk about before. Let's get going. If you're a subscriber, stay tuned to the end because we got the diet and supplement tips for you. This is key for anyone who wants hypertrophy, but also anyone who wants fat loss. So we'll give you the update. Stay tuned for that. Tip number one, you may know that there's two types of hypertrophy, theoretically, sarcoplasmic myofibrillar. Doesn't really matter the details right now, but there may be a subtype of a ladder of the myofibrillar contractile protein-based hypertrophy. What this means is that there's eccentric and concentric-based hypertrophy. This means in terms of practical application, if you are trained with concentric only, and you probably are, even if you don't realize it, I've talked about this in other videos, you're training concentric only, you are missing out on huge growth potential because you're missing on that eccentric overload hypertrophy. So how do you apply this? This doesn't mean doing eccentric reps when you're already fatigued the way most people do it. Get rid of that, doesn't matter. We're talking eccentric overload. This is the way you're going to get that eccentric hypertrophy. I talk about this in other videos. Be sure to check those out. There's a series on it. So we will get into that as we learn more. But for now, don't forget, hit that concentric hypertrophy, get the eccentric hypertrophy. We're starting to see if there's two different types. You gotta take advantage of both to get your maximum hypertrophy. Here's a bonus tip for you. What about BCAAs? That's a big one. Well, overall, unfortunately, BCAAs seem to not work. The research echoes that. Now, if you love BCAAs, not saying don't use them because I have a video on three quick tips for how to fix BCAAs. Going to my own lab research on muscle protein synthesis. This is going to be big information for anyone who wants to maximize BCAAs because right now, just dumping them into a protein shake doesn't seem to do anything. So we have to fix that. So we fix the BCAAs. I'll link to that in the top right. I'll link to it in the description. Definitely check that one out. Tip number two, this is a huge mistake that most people make, still not periodizing their programming, still doing just the same sets, same rep scheme, same loading scheme all the time. World Congress on Hypertrophy really emphasized the need to periodize. So you have periods of hypertrophy, then you have periods of strength training. So lower reps, heavier weight. This type of heavier loading scheme is going to cause maybe a little bit more of that myofibrillar hypertrophy, not quite that eccentric hypertrophy. It's still concentric based, but you need to mix up your program so you're stronger for your next hypertrophy phase. This is key. This is how you're going to have that stepwise increase in adaptation, growth. You're going to be able to recover better after these phases. It's going to change the way that you train and the way that you look. And don't forget, we're not just talking hypertrophy for the sake of muscle growth. This is also going to lead to fat loss as well. Remember, lifting training is lean training, okay? We're not just talking muscle growth. We're also talking fat loss, so overall body composition. So the key here is balance your strength phases and your hypertrophy phases. The strength phases are actually going to facilitate your growth during the hypertrophy phases. You're going to get bigger and stronger together. So don't skip out on it just because it's not direct hypertrophy training. Ultimately, in the long run, it's going to give you bigger gains. That's what you're after. Now, real quick, before we jump into diet and supplements, that is really hard to say. I want to hear from you. What are the supplements that you're using to facilitate your own hypertrophy? Are you using BCAAs, creatine, protein powders? Let me know in the comments below. Okay, tip number three. This is the big one, diet supplements. The big one everyone wants to know. I could do a whole other video on this. There was so much info, but I'll give you the overview right now. You can use this. The key here is the diet is important, but not if you're going over 1.6 grams per kilo of protein per day. It's not a ton of protein. It's more than most people are getting, but if you're a meathead like me, you're probably getting enough. Always a good idea to consume the casein at night, you know, have that slow protein before you go to bed. I have a whole video on that. If you need more, check that out. I think that's going to be a big one for you. But for most people, once you hit that 1.6 grams per kilo, protein's not going to do much if you have a high carb diet. Most people have a high carb diet, great for facilitating training, going to give you the mental energy to just get through the day. But if you drop the carbs, that's where you're going to need more protein. This is something I talk about in another video, especially facilitate fat loss. Fat loss not coming directly from a low carb diet, that doesn't matter. If you love it, awesome. do it. Just do it. Not a big deal. It's not bad. But know that if you are dropping your calories, dropping your carbs, you're going to need more protein. Your body's going to burn through it. Something called gluconeogenesis. Don't need to worry about the biochemical details right now. We can get into that in other videos if you want. Let me know. But for this one, 1.6 grams per kilo is the dose you want to maximize hypertrophy. Obviously, have your timing. Make sure you're not protein fasted. So again, have that casein at night. That's a big one. But otherwise, 1.6 grams for high carb. If you're going low carb, low cal, you're trying to just draw body fat, you're going to need to increase the protein a little bit more. But of course, if you are trying to draw body fat, you're probably not just looking to maximally increase hypertrophy. Yes, they are facilitated. I think we really need to get away from the idea that cardio training is going to be your lean training. No, lifting is lean training. This is something we really need to get out there. It's going to change the way people look at fat loss training. I talk about fat loss in another video. Be sure to check that one out. But for now, lean training, lifting training. Get the word out. We need to get rid of this cardio stuff. You should be doing cardio anyway. Great for your health, of course. But it's not the best way to burn fat. Burn fat is going to come through your muscle, going to come through that extra energy that you're burning throughout the day. It's not about what you burn in that hour of cardio, okay? That's ridiculous. We need to destroy that myth. I talk about this in another video. Be sure to check that out. Optimizing your body composition. This is something you're going to want to know. It's three tips for optimizing fat loss, muscle growth, that kind of thing. And it's a scientific-based but applied approach. Okay, that's the key. I always want this to be applied for you. Something you can pick up, use right away with yourself, your clients, your athletes, whatever it is. Applicability is the key. So in terms of application, what do? Well, you need to mix up your training. You need to get that eccentric overload and the concentric overload. Right now, again, you are training concentric only, even if you don't realize it. Yes, you might be trying to train eccentrics when you're fatigued. That's not what we're talking about. We're talking about heavy eccentric overload. There's a way to work up to that. Again, check out those videos. I'll link to it in the description and in the top right. But the key is to hit both heavy eccentric and concentric. Aside from the bigger picture, sarcoplasmic and myofibrillar hypertrophy, we'll talk about that in other videos. I'll be sure to link to those in the description and the top right. Plenty of information out there. So what does that mean? Again, mix up, periodize your program. That's the second tip, right? So we have strength phases and hypertrophy phases. Why do you want to do a strength phase with lower reps, longer rest periods? It's going to facilitate your hypertrophy gains, okay? That is key. Don't forget that. A lot of people skip it. I wish I had known about this when I was younger, but it's one of those things. If you could start this right away, you're going to have not only greater strength, but greater overall hypertrophy. So mix it up, periodize strength and hypertrophy, and you're going to ultimately have greater gains. Part number three was diet. Supplement at night with your casein or slow protein, whatever you want to do. It's not a direct recommendation. I am simply reviewing what was discussed. But again, there's a video about that, link to that in the top right and the description about the casein. Overall protein intake doesn't seem to benefit for people who are consuming eucaloric or higher caloric diets. Strictly going for hypertrophy, 1.6 grams per kilo a day seems to be where we top out. Doesn't really matter in terms of timing, other than you don't want to be protein fasted for the most part. You want to be carbed up for your workouts. So if you are dropping your carbs, dropping your cals, that's totally cool. Dropping carbs isn't going to specifically facilitate hypertrophy or fat loss. Not a big deal. If you love it, just keep doing it. That's great that you love it. But if you are going for maximal hypertrophy, 1.6 grams plus a higher calorie diet is the way to do it. If you are dropping your cals, you need to increase your protein intake. Your body's going to be burning through your actual body protein. It's going to be burning through the protein that you ingest. So you need to go above that 1.6 grams per kilo. I'm getting so excited. I'm losing my voice over this. I've been yelling for a while, but these are the key tips. Okay. So you got your diet, you got your training, you got your different intra workout tips. You got your extra workout tips, your programming, your long-term programming. All of this is going to ultimately facilitate hypertrophy. But I mean, there is so much info here. I could just keep going if my voice could hold out. We're going to cover this in future videos, so stay tuned. Be sure to check out the videos and links description. So here's your next steps for maximizing your hypertrophy and fat loss. So firstly, you're going to want to make sure you're doing the eccentric and concentric training. So again, right now you're doing concentric only. Whether or not you realize it, talk about that in other videos. And this is key. I will link to another video. This is a key handoff. Be sure to check out this video about maximizing your eccentric potential. There's a lecture I did on this. There's an eccentric training series. You're going to want to activate this type of hypertrophy, because right now you're missing out. Huge potential. It's not negative. you have a huge adaptive potential that you are just waiting to hack. This is why you're going to want to check out that next video. I'll link to it in the top right and in the description. No question, that is the next step for you. Thanks for watching. I'm David Barr. Until next time, raise the bar.